Hi friends! I've shared a few tutorials for how to use the symmetry tool in Procreate when drawing an illustration, and I'll add a link to a playlist if you want to check those out. Now in this video, I thought I'd walk you through all the different features of the symmetry tool and how you can use them to draw 8 easy digital doodles. If you're brand new to Procreate, the way you access the symmetry tool is by going to the Actions menu, this little wrench icon. Make sure you tap on Canvas and then tap Drawing Guide. The default drawing guide is going to be the 2D grid, but we want to change that. So tap Edit Drawing Guide, and you'll see a menu at the bottom of the screen with several options. You're going to tap Symmetry, then tap Done. By default, a vertical guide will appear in the middle of the canvas, and anything you draw on one side will be mirrored on the other side, as you can see here. But here's a tip. The vertical guide doesn't need to stay in the middle. If you go back to Edit Drawing Guide, then tap the blue dot in the middle of that guide, you can move it around to reposition it anywhere on the canvas. No matter where you position the guide, your artwork will still be mirrored on either side of that guideline. To move the guide back to the center, tap on the blue dot, then tap Reset. When you're in edit mode, you'll notice that there's also a green dot at the top of the guide. You can use this to change the angle of your guide. So if you want to draw several symmetrical objects in different positions on the same canvas, you have the flexibility to do that by moving your guide around. Again, to revert to the original position, tap on the green dot, then tap Reset. While you're still in that Edit Drawing Guide mode, if you tap on Options, you'll see even more options for the symmetry tool. The second option we can choose from is Horizontal Symmetry, which also mirrors your drawing, but on a horizontal axis. If we go back to options, the third choice is quadrant symmetry. With this setting, whatever you draw in one quadrant will appear in the other three quadrants. This is a really quick and easy way to play around with drawing mandalas or other detailed symmetrical doodles. The last option we have to choose from is radial symmetry. Now this works a lot like the quadrant symmetry, but it has 8 sections instead of just 4, which means you can create even more complex shapes with just a few strokes. This one is perfect for elaborate snowflake doodles.
There's another feature you can add to these symmetry options to create even more interesting effects. If you go back to Edit Drawing Guide, tap on Options, you'll see an option for rotational symmetry with a toggle switch. Let's tap that to turn it on, and we're going to see how this rotational symmetry works with each of the other symmetry options, starting with vertical. Now when rotational symmetry is on, it not only mirrors what you're drawing, it also flips it. So if I draw an arrow on the lower right side of the canvas, it will be duplicated on the upper left side. And as you can see, it's flipped, so it's changed directions as well.
So with this option, you can play around with different shapes to see what emerges.
Now, the great thing about the rotational feature is because the objects are kind of rotating around themselves, they don't meet in the middle. So this means that you can cross that center line, which just gives you more flexibility to play around. And I'll show you the difference. If I were to turn off rotational symmetry, and I'm just working with horizontal symmetry, and I make that same arc, as you can see, it kind of overlaps itself because it's just mirroring exactly what you're doing on the other side. But with rotational symmetry on, I can draw that same arc and cross the center line because it's rotating around itself. It's not meeting in the middle.
Okay, back to that doodle. Now let's try quadrant symmetry with rotation. With this option, you can create a little more movement in your floral doodles. By the way, if you'd like to learn how to draw a leafy wreath using this feature, click the link above for an easy tutorial. And finally, let's try the radial guides with rotational symmetry. This is a great way to experiment with fun spiral doodles. A couple final things to note. Keep in mind that Drawing Assist works for both drawing and erasing elements. The first time you turn on the symmetry guides on a new canvas, it will automatically activate Drawing Assist on the current layer. But every time you create a new layer, you'll notice that Drawing Assist does not automatically turn on. You'll need to manually turn on Drawing Assist to activate it on each new layer. Keep in mind that with all of the symmetry guides, you can adjust the position of the guide by tapping on the blue dot, or adjust the tilt of the guide by tapping on the green dot. If you want to add a few asymmetrical elements to your drawing, you can simply turn off Drawing Assist on that layer to exit the mirroring mode. Now you can draw like you normally would. And there you have 8 quick and easy doodles you can draw in Procreate with the help of the Symmetry tool. I hope you found this video helpful, and I hope you're inspired to create some fun symmetrical doodles of your own. I turned the 8 doodles I created into downloadable coloring pages, which are available on my Patreon. You can find the coloring pages, as well as phone wallpaper downloads, bonus videos, and more by joining my Patreon community starting at just $3 a month. I hope to see you there. If you enjoyed this video, I'd also love it if you'd give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!